E agora a gente vai mostrar a entrevista que a gente fez com o Florian, com o Michael B. Jordan e com a Tessa Thompson, uma entrevista pro Creed 2. Mas o que importa é o seguinte, a gente teve duas oportunidades de conversar com eles, o Pedro foi conversar com eles na CCXP e eu fui pra Filadélfia a convite da Warner Brothers pra viver uma espécie de Creed Experience. Eu fui lá comer Philly Cheesecake no lugar que aparece no filme, que aparece no Rocky 1, que aparece no Creed 1. Eu tive a oportunidade de ter uma aula de boxe na academia do Mickey, cara, foi uma parada muito maneira. Quem é fã de Rocky, quem é fã de Creed, entende esse sentimento, estar lá, fazer uma aula de boxe lá, cara, uma aula de boxe puxada, ninguém pegou leve não. Então vê aí como é que foi.
Stop the bag. Somebody come to you, you're not going to say, hey, stop there so I can hit you, okay? You're just going to hit him, okay? Go for it. Good. Do it again. Beautiful. Right hand here, okay? Left hook here. And a right hand here. Jab. Right hand. No, no, straight.
Sorry,
straight.
Sorry.
Don't be sorry. Now, when I go like this, all right, you're going to bend. You're going to step with your left foot over there. Turn the hook, then the right hand. You're gonna go that way with your back foot. Then you're gonna go the right hand, left hook, right hand. Try it again. Left hook, right hand. You ready? Sure?
More than a revenge movie and a movie about overcoming the difficulties, this movie is about daddy issues.
Definitely a lot of daddy issues.
Man. What do you think about that?
Yeah, I think it's spot on. I think inherently from, you know, Rocky IV, which sent us down this path that we didn't really see coming years ago, is this relationship between fathers and sons, the lack thereof, the pressures of their life, the huge shadow that they cast upon the children. And
in Creed 1, Adonis has the shadow in the beginning of the movie. Mm-hmm. You can see him after he finds Rocky. He's like a father figure for him.
He is. Rocky is definitely a father figure for Adonis, and you know, their relationship through the first two films. You know, it's a roller coaster. They have their ups and downs, like any relationship. But you know, at the end of the day, I think they really care about each other, and they want the best for each other.
And about Victor with Ivan Drago. Yeah.
Well, you know, it was very easy for me to fit in into this project and to connect to this character, because family is the most important thing in our lives. I speak for you too here.
Yeah.
And my father is maybe the most important person in my life, my best friend, my mentor. So all I want to do, I do for him. Like, I want to see him proud. Same for Victor. Everything he does, he does for his father, right? Not really sure he is so much into fighting, but he knows that his father really wants him to do that and redeem the family
legacy,
name and stuff. So yeah, I really can connect to that goal, like make your father proud, make your family proud.
If you want to fight this man, that's your business. But don't pretend this is about your father.
So I really like the movie, and everybody that I talked, everyone that I've talked said that they've cried too. So did you expect this while you were shooting?
Yeah, we knew we had a lot of emotional scenes and moments in this movie. Adonis, you know, with Victor,
Tessa, you know, the baby, you know, there's a lot with Rocky, you know, he's dealing with a lot with his son. Sometimes I've been worried it might be too emotional.
Yes.
Yeah, we thought it might be too emotional, but yeah, but I think we always kind of felt that way.
We were crying in love.
Yes, yeah, exactly. So hoping people will feel
yeah. I gotta take the fight. He's got nothing to lose. When a fighter ain't got nothing to lose, he's dangerous.
Adonis and Hate Victors have something more in common. They are fighting for other people's battle. They are fighting Apollo battle, they are fighting Rocky battle, Ivan battle.
Mm-hmm.
How that feels? Why people fight other people's battle?
That's a tough question. Well, you know, if it wouldn't be their way, of course, our world would be a lot easier. I mean, I think most of the problems that we have in general is not because we have some personal issues, but it's because of a bigger ego, if that makes sense.
Yeah.
And if it comes down to our movie, like, it's definitely not that we two have a problem, like Victor and Donnie. It's definitely a problem which lasts in the past of the Apollo and Ivan and Rocky.
Mm-hmm.
But again, then we making it our problems because people expecting a lot from us, telling Donnie, you have to redeem your father. I want to redeem my father too, because he got abandoned from his country. And we're taking these problems, those problems with us, because we want to see our parents proud, right? We want to make them proud, make our fathers proud, make our families proud. So yeah, it's a tough question here to answer.
No, it's a multi-layered question. Yeah, yeah. You did a good job, though. That's good.
Because of you, I lose everything.
So Bianca is a musician and lives for her music, and I want to know about your relationship with music. I know I heard that you also wrote some songs that are in the movies.
Okay. I have a huge relationship with music. I come from a musical family. My dad's a musician, so I grew up literally part-time in a music studio. I use music a lot in my process with work. I always make playlists for characters. It's really helpful. It's like a shorthand to get into emotional spaces. And I listen to tons of music just in my life. So in a way, it was really daunting to play Bianca and to know that I would be tasked with performing and writing original music, because I have such respect for musicians. But that's been the beauty of playing the part.
One thing that's great from the Rocky franchise, the training scenes, right?
Mm-hmm.
And yours was amazing. The scene that you stand up is like a superhero or something, I don't know what to say.
Well,
how hard was it? Because you carried things that I don't know, maybe it's heavy as me. Can you tell me about it?
No, I mean the training, yeah, it was fun, man. That moment where I got up, you know, it was definitely like, you know, a little anime inspired. You know, like, some Goku in there, you know. Yeah. So, a little Gohan. Those are the fun parts, the real fun parts, you know what I'm saying? And what people expect to get from these movies. So we wanted to do something different, you know, go into the desert. We haven't seen that really the montage before in that atmosphere. And, you know, this guy's a beast. So, you know, being able to do things that you know, that other, you know, actors in that position wouldn't have been able to do. It was a real blessing for us.
People like me, we live in the past. You got people that need you now.
In the movie, we see many things happen to Bianca all the same time. In one scene, you are pregnant and you have to walk like this, you know, because suddenly.
We'll see that again. How did that go?
I'll see.
Good, you got that.
And then you are mother, then you are singing professionally. Is that different from you? Is it like a challenging to record, to shoot so many different things at one time?
No. I think, and the truth is, that's the case for so many women. There's so many women that are that dynamic. They're mothers, they're career women, they got so much going on. They're wearing so many hats. So to me, it just felt like honest, because those are the women I know. Those are the women in my life. They're all like that. And it's exciting for me to have a lot to do in these spaces. I think it's disappointing when you go into the cinema and you see a character, any character, but particularly when it's a woman, that feels like she's, you know, one-dimensional.
I like one scene especially, that's you enter the house and you say, babe, just take care of the kid a little bit because I need to go. It seems really real. Do you have a favorite scene?
I really like that scene, actually.
Yes.
Because I also like what it says. I also like what it says just in terms of in film that, like, here, take the baby, guy. Like, this isn't something that only women have to do. We shouldn't only be confined to, you know, the space of domesticity. That, you know, so I like that, that that's a shared thing. I really like that scene. I'll take it. I really love the scene too when they're talking about having the baby and she says, I'm not gonna be, you know, barefoot and pregnant making you sandwiches. That was something that I actually said to Mike when we FaceTime and he pitched this idea of them having a child. And I said that to him and then we put it in the script. So I really like that too.
I want to talk about you because you talk about the scene that you speak in Russian or Ukraine, I don't know. How was that? Because you had to memorize it. I could have done it, I believe I did.
Yeah, I mean, we had a couple of lines in Russian and that made it into the movie. And Steven and me, our director, mm-hmm. and we were working prior to the shooting, like 3 months before. Same with Mike for the choreography and mm-hmm. he went through all his scenes. So I had those lines already locked in like 2 months before we shot the movie. So I can focus on the acting mm-hmm. and not focusing on the lines because I'm not a Russian. I'm not speaking Russian. Mm-hmm. And trust me, this language is a real tongue taker.
Yeah.
So that's how I.
It's a movie about fighting, of course, but also about family and purpose. And I would like to know what motivates you, because it's really a straight routine while shooting and all that.
Yeah, yeah.
And what motivates you when you get up and say, you know, one more day to shoot?
I think both of us, you know, I'm going to say two things, and I'm pretty sure it's going to be the same for him, but it's like family first and then our own legacy. You know, I think those are two things that like motivate me every day. You know, family is most important, and then building something that, you know, I can be proud of, that people can be proud of, that, you know, that help people, you know, when I'm gone.
The same?
It's really the same. Like,
he knows how to.
Round after round, you learn more about yourself. And when I stepped in that ring, it wasn't all about me.